messenger, as a forerunner, as a harbinger. Remember, Sir Raven. Remember the peacock, the level of the peacock, the infinite colors of the imagination. Remember the swan, you must serve the higher aims of the race.
The lion.
A consciousness unified with the consciousness of the race. The lion.
Early in the afternoon of April 30th, 1945, Adolf Hitler committed suicide in a bomb-proof bunker beneath the Chancellery of the Third Reich in Berlin. Russian troops took control of the city that same day. The war in Europe was over. The remnants of Hitler's empire, the last few faithful followers, fled in all directions. Many survived, some were caught. And 21 of the top Nazi officials were brought to trial at Nuremberg for crimes against civilization. Crimes that resulted in the deaths of countless millions of people on battlefields from one end of Europe to the other. And in the death camps, Dachau, Belsen, Sachsenhausen, and a dozen others, the German SS committed unspeakable atrocities. How did it happen? How did an insignificant Austrian rise to such incredible heights? Adolf Hitler set out to conquer the world. He almost did. But he had to have help. He surrounded himself with the best Germany had to offer. Military strategist, scientist, engineers, propagandist. And Hitler was not the first dictator in history to seek help outside the ordinary, to try to harness powers beyond the natural. He had a fully staffed occult bureau, astrologers, numerologists, psychics. He collected objects reputed to have great occult powers, and for the first time in history, he combined pure science and the occult. At one of the death camps, Sachsenhausen, north of Berlin, a team of select scientists under the eminent neuropathologist Ernst von Staudt worked on what Hitler believed to be the most important project in Nazi Germany. His success in this area is only recently being brought to light. That von Staudt's experiments were daring and unprecedented is known. That he enjoyed great favor with Hitler is known. That von Staudt and his colleagues escaped after the war is known. But the exact nature of his experiments and what became of his research is not known. Adolf Hitler, in his last will and testament, declared the Nazi movement would not die with him. That through the work of Ernst von Staudt, he had planted the seed that would one day, in his words, grow into the glorious rebirth of the Fourth Reich.
Thank you. My children, the time has come at last. The time we have prayed for so long. The time, as it was foretold by our leader, we have achieved the level of the lion. We have walked the long path as it was ordained for us to walk through the time of the raven. And soon, it will be the time of the eagle. Adler on Grife.
It is the time of the eagle.
Ah! Chris, what's wrong? What is it?
I'm okay. It's a dream. Another bad dream.
Why don't you lie back and try to rest?
No, it's time to get up anyway.
It is. Yeah, I'll accept the charges.
Hi, Mary. How's it going? Fine. Hey, how's Kathy? Good. No, I wouldn't forget a thing like that. What? Why? At her age... Listen, I'm really sorry about that. I just don't have the money. Now, I don't care what you heard. I can't get an advance on it.
Tell you what I'll do. I can send half of the back payments by the end of the month.
That all right? Okay? Good. Love to Kathy. Bye. Did you know that alimony is the only debt you can still be put in jail for? The last vestige of debtor's prison. My dear ex-wife is ready to slam the cell door on me. What in hell does a 16-year-old girl need with braces?
So, Adolf Hitler became Chancellor of Germany, proving once again that you can win through intimidation. There are some historians who think Hitler had an ace in the hole, the so-called Spear of Longinus, an old Roman relic he picked up in Vienna. Legend has it that the spear holds the key to ruling the world, that it has satanic powers. And it is true that when he got it in 1936, he did seem to get his second wind. Strange, too, that nobody seems to know where it is now.
Then in 1938, Hitler took Austria. Probably because he couldn't get any really first-rate Viennese pastry in Berlin. Did you get the lights, please? Yes.
Forgive me, Professor, but you don't seem to be taking these things very seriously.
I'm sorry, I was thinking of something else. You don't think I take this seriously, is that right? I'm sorry if it seems that way to you. But it's pretty damned hard to look at Hitler face on, because what he did was so monstrous, so unbelievable, so... so insane... I laugh at Hitler, it is nervous laughter. I was there. I lived through it. That's a hell of a lot different from reading about it in a book or looking at pictures of it on a screen. You may go.
History students think the world began yesterday.
It did.
Joint's going to seed, Jake.
Oh, Knuckles over there. One of Potts' new boys. Used to play special teams for the Packers.
Potts been in?
No, but I get inquiries. You were on the list.
Oh, shit.
You went to Potts for much?
What's the difference? Potts and his Packers will bust your arm for quarter.
Dumb to bet football.
Where is it written?
College professors are exempt from dumb. I'm 3 months behind in alimony. I'm a sucker for the Steelers, and my kid needs braces. On top of that, my ex-wife thinks I make a lot of money. State University, for God's sake.
What are my taxes for?
I gotta get some money.
I think that would be a good plan.
What can I do for you?
Got some stuff here.
Okay, come on back. You want to sell or pawn?
What's the most money?
I'm selling. Listen, the market right now for cameras is pretty good. I can probably make you a very nice offer on this.
Great.
You got any other lenses?
No, just the 55.
Uh-huh. Where'd you get this?
Germany, during the war. Souvenir.
Have you fired it?
No.
It's very well kept. Tell you, I can go as high as $300 on this item. I know a collector. He'll turn green. These other things, though, the dagger, well, they're a dime a dozen. Oh, the metal. Well, you never know. I'll ask my collector. All right, let me see. You got the camera. 50, the pistol, 300, the tape machine, what can I tell you? $15. The dagger, 10. I tell you what, I'm gonna take a chance. What do you say to $100 for the metal?
That would be nice.
It comes to 475. Oh, you'll have to fill out your name and address here for the police. They like to know where I buy my guns. But you want cash.
That's why I'm here.
Right. Always deal in cash. I mean, how do I know who prints checks? The money, I know who prints that. There you go. It's a pleasure doing business with you.
Thank you.
Feldman, this is Saul Greenberg.
You still looking for Nazi stuff?
Good.
A fella just left off some things I think you might find interesting. There's this medal, the Order of the Eagle, it says in my book. Mint condition. Inscription? Yeah, wait a minute. Yeah, it says Von Stott. Yeah, I'm sure of it. Von Stott. V-O-N-S-T-O-T-T.
That's fine.
That's pretty extravagant. I've never seen you like this.
It's Berncastle. Estate bottled. I remember it was in June or July of 45. And one night a bunch of the guys and myself liberated almost an entire truckload of Berncastle. What a drunk.
You never used to talk that much about the war, except in class. Now you don't talk about anything else.
You know, the odd thing is, I don't really remember much about the war. I was a prisoner for nearly a year. It was a dumb thing, really. I guess they treated us pretty well under the circumstances. I used to play chess with a commandant.
Chris? Are you all right?
I was trying to think of something.
I was trying to talk to you about that. It seems you're not here half the time.
I guess I was thinking about the alimony and finishing up the quarter. Hey, look, finals are next week. Why don't we just pack up and head off for the beach for a few days, hmm? We'll stay drunk and naked and sunburned the entire time.
It's not normal for people to have headaches all the time.
Yeah, I know. It says so right on the aspirin bottle.
Why don't you see a doctor?
I know. I have seen more doctors in the last 30 years than I want to think about. Now, they all say the same thing. It is psychosomatic. There is nothing physically wrong.
What about a psychiatrist?
For my ex-wife, I left the priesthood. Now, if this keeps up for you, I will go back into it. Eat your noodles.
Herr Zahlmann, Ihr Telefonanruf nach New York ist bereit.
Danke. Hi, Mr. Feldman? Yeah, my name is Hans Zahlmann. I'm an investigator with the Procurator's Office at the State Court of Hessen in Frankfurt. Yeah. Yeah, we received some information from your people yesterday about Von Stott. Yeah. Yeah, the name I have here is William Christopher, is that correct? Yeah. Do you have any more information about him? Yeah, I'll be leaving this morning. We think this one is definitely worth the trip. We very much appreciate your cooperation with this matter. Doc.
Stick it to you, I would like to explain a little bit about how I arrived at your final. Back when I was a young seminarian at St. Mary's in Baltimore, we had a rather brutal theology professor. We all dreaded his finals because they were notoriously unreasonable. Well, one semester we all filed in for the bloodletting and were horrified to find that before we arrived, he had written the single question of the exam on the board. Crook crooks. Why the cross? Two words. That was it. You can understand our confusion. What he wanted was an explanation of the cross throughout the history of the church, and especially the role of the cross in the church's crusade to save souls. I wrote 20 pages and got a C-, as I recall. With that in mind, and keeping in mind what we have discussed about the social, political, and economic situation in Europe during the 1920s, here is your final exam. Why Hitler? Good hunting. You have 3 hours.
Authentic, definitely. And von Staudt is the man we're after. What do you know about Christopher?
Not much, really. He teaches at the college. I have his address. He said it was some kind of souvenir.
No, this is no souvenir. Von Staudt was a high-ranking research scientist. He was with Mengele at Auschwitz. And he's right after Mengele on our list. We have reports of him being in Argentina as recently as last year. Christopher may know nothing. One thing is certain, wherever he got this medal, it's no souvenir. I'd like to pursue it.
I don't really understand you.
What do you mean?
Well, here it is 30 years later, and you're chasing Nazis. I don't understand. You're not Jewish.
No, I'm German.
You see, for myself, I'm as anxious as any Jew to see all of them rounded up. Von Staudt, Mengele. Mengele. My sister died at Mengele's hands. My brothers died at Belsen. But you, what have you lost? You were a baby when it all happened.
It was my father's. Do you know what it is?
No.
It's a service ribbon for the winter campaign. My father died at Stalingrad.
Hmm.
Not in battle. He wasn't killed by a Russian bullet. My father froze to death in a snow-covered bunker during the winter siege. And 80,000 German soldiers died with him. Punishment from the Führer. He would not withdraw them. He would not send them food or blankets or supplies. They were being punished because I could not beat the Russian army. So you ask what I lost. I lost a father. And Germany lost a generation of fathers. They were good Germans, they did what they were told, and Hitler killed them. I chased Nazis, as you put it, because I, too, am a good German.
It's only fair to warn you, I'm not your type.
And who would know that better than me? My name is Hans Sormann. I'm from the West German Police Department.
Thank God. I thought you were from my bookie.
No, but I would like to speak with you for a moment.
Okay.
Since 1950, the state courts of Germany have... West Germany, I suppose I should say,
I've had the responsibility for the investigation of Nazi war crimes.
I know. I teach history.
Yeah, of course, I'm sorry. Forgive me. So, of course, you also know that many of our files are still open. The medal you pawned brought you to our attention. It's a very rare medal. Where did you get it?
Well, at the end of the war, there were a lot of souvenirs just lying around Germany waiting to be picked up. I got this one, a dagger, gun, the usual stuff. Jesus, there must have been thousands of GIs with duffel stuff full of Nazi gear.
Yeah, that is true. But there are very few medals of the kind you had. And there is only one von Stadt.
I've only read about him.
That is odd. He was at the camp where you were held. At Sachsenhausen, von Stadt was in charge of the brain research. Says they developed a nerve agent that, well, fortunately, before they were able to use it, the war ended. They experimented mostly upon the Jews, but there were some reports that some of the Allied prisoners of war were also experimented upon. We don't know the extent of the research because all the records were destroyed, or so the Russians tell us.
Why go to so much trouble chasing tired old Nazis?
You know, twice today before I've been asked that question. Once by an old Jew who couldn't understand why one German should be chasing another German. People think I'm wasting my time and my government's money, but I don't agree. It wasn't that long ago, and we have no guarantee that Hitler could not happen again. Some people seem to think the world began yesterday.
Do you know, twice before today, I have said the same thing myself. Where do you go from here?
Home, I suppose. If there's nothing more you can tell me.
I wish I could help. I don't know what to say. Von Stadt is a name in a book.
And the medal?
Terrible. I haven't been able to help more. I'd like to make it up to you. My place is right over there. At least I could offer you a drink.
You know, on the way over from the airport this morning, I heard an American folk song. Would you like me to sing it for you?
Sure.
You took my heart and stomped that sucker flat.
You know, I wish you could talk to my students.
Why, say, I've never seen a real-life German?
No, it's not that. It's just that they're so damn young. Well, it's hard to convey to them what the war was about. All they know about is Vietnam.
What could I tell them? I was 5 years old when it ended.
You tell them what you learned after the war, what you remember.
What I learned was to beg from the GIs. I remember our bombed out buildings. I grew up in a small village called Fürth, near Nuremberg. We weren't very important, but we had a factory that manufactured gyroscopes and opticals for bomb sites. So we became a target. There was hardly a building left standing. I'm sorry.
I cannot. You have been too
kind. Oh, no, you can sleep on the sofa.
Now,
listen, I can probably get the car out and take you to town and find you a hotel, but I don't think I could find my way home.
I'll stay here on the floor by the fire. What can I say?
Well, you can say good night.
Good night? Mm.
John's down the hall.
Who?
Bathroom.
Oh, yeah, danke.
Thank you.
Who are they?
Oh, it's my fault.
What do they want with him?
I shouldn't have done it.
I don't understand any of this.
It's my fault.
Where are they taking him?
I
don't understand. Who's von Stott? Who is von Stott? I don't understand.
Shut up on that face, I know you think!
I think they're going to the airport.
But he's very busy at this time of night.
I understand his problem, but this is an emergency. We need to stop
the airplane. Take care of it. Please, take it easy, mister. I'm doing the best I can. Now, you wait right here. Huh? You wait right here.
This is a matter of extreme emergency. I need you to stop an airplane. There's been a kidnapping. Do you understand? There's been a kidnapping. I need you to stop
it. Well, I was going
to
call my FAA.
Stop the airplane first. I'll put you in touch with your Secretary of State.
Clear 425, Romeo Delta cleared for takeoff. Tower Williams. No, I can't stop him. Not unless you want the Air Force to shoot him down.
What can we do now?
Well, Reynolds, this is Farmer. Listen, there's a guy here. He's some kind of policeman. He needs a rundown on that Learjet that just took off from here. Yeah, it's 425RD.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, right. Well, it's a private charter out of Miami. They have a flight plan back to Miami and then to South America. They got the legit papers. They told the customs officers down there that they were coming to pick up a sick man. And they have papers on him, too, so I guess everything's in order. Is that a long-distance call?
How long before that plane reaches Miami?
About 2.5, 3 hours. Well, not necessarily.
How can you make some circles airport in one of those holding things?
That's one of the things we do.
Do it for me. Yeah, Jack? Yeah, this is Hans Solomon. I'm sorry to wake you up. Yeah, I'm in this country. Jack, I'm sorry. This is an emergency. I need your help. Yeah. What time does your next commercial plane leave for Miami?
Oh, well, that would be your flight 781. And that's
hold
at
it
gate 9
me.
At the...
Hold it. Yeah. Yeah, done. Look, I want you to speak with this man. His name is John Armstrong. He's with your State Department. Listen very carefully to what he says and do exactly as he tells you.
Hello?
Attention, please, Mr. Charles Bridges. Please come to the customer service counter at Piedmont Airlines.
I don't have time to explain very much to you right now, but you must trust me. And most importantly, trust Chris. As he says I took Chris, I want him, and I'm going after him. I'll bring Chris back home to you safe and sound, I promise. You must believe me.
Second officer is going to be joining you in Miami.
Clarify.
All we know is it's pretty important. You'll stay in a holding pattern for about a half hour, and you are not, I repeat, not to discuss this with your clients.
Roger.
Running late?
We're in a holding pattern. A lot of traffic tonight.
Ain't that the pits? I remember once we were stuck over O'Hare. Jesus, what a flight. But we ran out of booze and everything.
Zalman, Mike Jones, these are your instructions for Captain Eskridge. Uniforms down the hall. Told the tower to get them down, and as soon as you're changed, we'll get you on board. I sure hope this works.
You hope it works.
We're getting a new second officer here in Miami. Strictly routine.
Thank you.
Sergeant.
Yeah. Arismendi's Federal Police.
They're already gone. We must hurry. Where's your car?
There is no need to hurry. I know where they're going.
We must follow them.
No, I cannot help you.
I don't understand. There has been a crime committed. There's international law.
Sometimes. I received instructions from your government. I understand your problem. But I simply cannot help you. These people you want, they are very powerful. They have the protection of the government. They came here many years ago. They have much money. Perón gave them protection.
Perón is dead.
These people can buy any government they want.
I see. Can you at least tell me where I might find some myself? Can you get me a car?
It is very dangerous for me. But I can get you a car.
Thank you.
Ah, I see you found the clothing. Well, it's been quite some time since I saw you last, so we couldn't be quite sure of your tastes. Hmm? I understand your reticence, and I can appreciate your confusion. You've had a rough night, but I'm afraid we had no alternative. Regrettable as I find such methods to be.
What do you want? Who are you?
Oh, I forgot. You don't remember. I am Ernst von Staudt.
I am Ernst von Staudt.
We want your help. Dr. Christopher, we ask your cooperation for only a short time. At the end of this period, you'll be free to go wherever you will. Ah, I miss our little game. That was foolish, Dr. Christopher. Foolish indeed. You must know there is no way out.
There's a man after you.
There are many men after me. Scorzani, a big day for us, is it not?
I hope so, for all our sakes. A great deal is at stake.
I am aware of the stakes.
I spoke with B this morning. He's most anxious that we keep to our timetable. Everything depends on it.
You know, I was quite fond of your father. He had the quality of patience. He understood time and its uses.
Time, Dr. von Staudt, is running short. In Montevideo, in Los Angeles, in Madrid, all of our people are ready. And patience. Patience is in very short supply.
Just so. It has always been. I don't know why that should change. I remember when Himmler came to see me once in Sachsenhausen. He wanted the gas we were working on, and he could not understand why I could not give it to him. It was not perfected. It could have destroyed our own troops as well. He said, "That does not matter. The German soldier's duty is to destroy the enemies of the fatherland, regardless of cost." Has it occurred to you, young Scorzani, this thing we are creating, that we will loose on the world to lead us to victory, could indeed lead us to total destruction?
No, it has not.
You are indeed your father's son.
I think I've taken up enough of your time this morning. I'll see you in the meeting this afternoon. I look forward to your report.
Well, Katrina, will this thing work?
Yes.
The stars say it will work. Somehow, I am not consoled.
Siegfried, Colibri, Longinus. One, two, three, four.
Remember the raven. The raven. The raven. The messenger. The forerunner. The harbinger.
Harbinger.
Remember the raven. The raven. Remember the peacock.
Peacock.
The peacock. The level of the peacock. The mind's colors. The infinite colors of the imagination.
Colors.
The power of the colors. Remember the swan. Swan, you must die to the selfish desires. You must serve the higher aims, the higher aims of the race. The swan.
The pelican.
Pelican.
The pelican lives.
And now, William, Christopher, do you trust me?
Yes, Doctor.
Good. You have made a good beginning. Now you must rest. It will be a slow process, but he seems to be responding. We must take him back through every level, through every step to be certain. And, of course, you must do your part.
Members of the council, Christopher is here. He is well. We have undergone an initial session under hypnotic suggestion. He responded perfectly, though the suggestion was implanted in his mind over 30 years ago. I think we owe a debt of gratitude to Dr. Schmidt and Dr. Hertz for their pioneering work in hypnotherapy. Now we proceed to the more intricate levels of the procedure. As you know, Christopher was chosen from hundreds of prisoners tested for this ultimate experiment. His time of birth, his brain, his charts, his background and training all conform perfectly to our requirements. His Jesuit training, in particular, presents us with a mind accustomed to accepting complex, abstract, and mystical concepts. Owing to his work done in genetics by Dr. Jensen, we were able to make great strides for our time. What remains for us to find out, and we will find out, is whether the information planted in Christopher's subconscious 30 years ago has indeed taken root and can indeed be made to germinate and flourish.
Aloe vera, lily of life. And youth. And strength. Lie still. Stay young. Be strong. You will never know the pain of weakness. You will never know sorrow. You will never grow old. Sleep now. Sleep. 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 And dream no more.
Move Christopher to another room deeper in the complex.
Thank you.
God, how did you get here?
Carefully. Are you all right?
You've got to get me out of here.
I have to get Von Staudt first, then we'll go.
No. Now. It has to be now. You don't understand what... Somehow I'm a part of this thing. It's already begun. If you wait any longer, it'll be too late to stop them.
I will stop them. But I need help. As the local authorities have refused to cooperate with me, I must get in touch with my own people.
Hans, you're crazy. You got in here. You can get me out now. Take me and you beat them. They want me.
I want Von Staudt.
Why?
Because thousands of people have died because of this man, and he must pay for thousands. You are only one.
One.
You will wait.
Whatever happens to me happens tomorrow.
I will be there.
You'll understand more fully after today the true import of your contribution here. The brain, the human brain, is a remarkable creation. And your brain, in particular, is a repository of the hopes and dreams of a new generation. Thank you. Christopher has responded more readily than we could ever have hoped. It is the day of the final rites of the Eagle. The day when our Führer will rise and lead us to the ultimate victory. Christopher is ready to take his rightful place at our head. Longinus, the talisman of power the Führer claimed as his own so long ago. The spear of the centurion, the spears that pierced the side of Jesus on Calvary. The Grail considered holy by the outsiders, carried by Arimathea to Cornwall, carried by Barbarossa to the Fatherland. The Grail the Führer claimed as his own so long ago.
Thank you. is. Don't you recognize me?
Move, Arnstadt!
Chris, it's me. I've come to take you home.
Thank you.